Hello everyone, I am Levin. In this video, I will discuss about topological superconductors and the Majorana zero mode. To start, why care about them? Topological superconductors are a component of a topological quantum computer. There is a quantum computing system where its operation is based on topology. What is topology? Topology is a field in mathematics that concerns the properties of shapes such that only the large-scale properties matter. These properties include the number of surfaces, number of holes, and the number of sides. One popular example is showing that a mug is the same as a donut. The mug can be continuously deformed to obtain the donut. Another example is the Mobius band, a shape which only has one edge. Until recently, topology is considered a branch of mathematics that has no real-life application. So how does it apply? It started with an experiment that proved that Hall resistance can be quantized and named the quantum Hall effect. In a standard Hall experiment, a current is applied and material is placed in a magnetic field. Then, the moving charged particles deflect due to the magnetic field, producing an electric potential that can be measured. However, in a 2D flat material under an extremely strong magnetic field, we expect the electrons to move in very small circles and unable to carry current, effectively an insulator. But results show that there is measurable current, and the flat areas show the quantization of Hall resistance, and thus the topological insulator is discovered. What causes this effect? It is true that the bulk material remains as an insulator. This is one of the topological classes. The vacuum is another topological class, but the electrons in the edge behave differently. They travel along the entire edge of the material. The conduction along the edge is a physical representation of the electrons having to transform from one topological class to another. The electrons need to change from the energy states of an insulator to the energy state of a vacuum. The electron closes this gap at the boundary by forming a metallic edge. Now, let us replace the insulator with a superconductor. Since a superconductor is already a bulk conductor at these low temperatures, we have conflicting ideas. As it turns out, quasi-particles can exist in superconductors. They are not real particles like electrons, but we can mathematically treat them as particles to predict their behavior. In a superconductor, they are called Bogoliubov quasi-particles, described by the following equation. In topological superconductors specifically, it was suggested that a new particle can be found, the Majorana particle. Before further discussion, we must first know what are Majorana particles. Majorana particles are particles that are their own antiparticles. This is an interesting alternative to the typical solution of the Dirac equation. Solutions to the Dirac equation usually represent fermion particles, such as electrons, protons, and neutrons, that have their respective antiparticles. This is because the solutions are complex, and hence the conjugate solutions, which represent the antiparticles, are also unique solutions. However, Ettore Majorana proposed an alternative solution to the Dirac equation where the solution is real and hence the conjugate is itself. The implication is that the corresponding solution particle is also its own antiparticle. So how exactly are superconductors a candidate to finding these particles? Let us go back to the Bogoliubov quasi-particles. The equations that define these particles look quite similar to the equations that define the Majorana particle. If the particles are adjusted such that U and V are conjugates of each other, we could show that the Bogoliubov particle satisfies the conditions for Majorana particles. As a result, researchers are looking for the Majorana zero mode. This is zero energy state of the Majorana particle. It is a state where Majorana particles can remain stable and form as quasi-particles that we can use for quantum computing. These particles come in pairs, and a pair of Majorana particles can form a single regular fermion. These Majorana pairs are in fact entangled with each other, but remain physically separated. This is an important property of the system. The physical separation is a core part of topological quantum computing. Our problem, as of early 2021, is that there are disagreements on whether or not we have found these Majorana zero modes. The particles are as mysterious as the physicists that hypothesize them. We have theories that predict that it is possible, but experimental measurements don't have fully convincing evidence of MZMs. The graph you see here is from 2015 from Professor Sankar Dasarma, proving that finding these particles are at least possible. Since then, we have improved experimental techniques to try and firmly prove that the particle exists. But the difficulty to prove this existence convinced some experts, including Professor Sarma himself, that if the theory did not exist, experimental results and the paper that includes them would be rejected by editors. Those who say that we have not found MZMs claim that the signals detected are caused by other factors or even just noise in the sample. But okay, let's say we have proven MZMs exist. There is strong evidence for them. What happens next? Meyer nanoparticles are considered non-abelian anions, which are two-dimensional quasi-particles that keep record of their position and orientation. As a result, if we switch the location of two non-abelian anions, we can distinguish that such a change can occur. In comparison, if we switch the position of two electrons, we would have never noticed such exchange happened. Hence, we can use this measurement at a later time and use it for manipulating data. This allows scientists to consider a topological system of braid groups as information manipulation. As a topological system, it is resistant against small variations. To demonstrate, we can have braid A and braid B. A and B are distinctly different and correspond to different data. Now let us say we have an extremely messy braid C. If you look carefully, braid A and C are topologically the same. You can pull the ends of braid C until you get braid A without changing the relationship of the system. You can go ahead, pause the video, get some string, and try it for yourself. This tolerance to local errors allow for error-tolerant encoding of quantum information. We can also perform operations. If we connect the ends of braid A to the start of braid B, the combined braid can be seen here as braid D. So in order to produce computational operators, four non-abelian anions are required for one unit of information, which translates to four MZMs make one qubit. But from further investigation, scientists are more convinced that it requires six MZMs, as two are required to measure the data encoded in the qubit. In finding MZMs, two main mediums are used. The first method is using a flat sheet of a superconductor. The holes are produced into the sheet, and those added holes are expected to produce Meyer nanoparticles. We can check the presence of MZMs by using a scanning tunneling microscope. Another method is to have a nanowire, and the MZMs are expected to be found at the two ends of the wire. In both methods, the STM moves towards the point that we expect to find MZMs, and then electrons can tunnel more easily through them. We can detect this electron tunneling as current through the sample. The electrons can do this because the zero energy state of the MZMs act as a stepping stone towards the ground, and therefore closing the circuit. Thank you very much for watching until the end. If you're interested in knowing more about topological superconductors and Meyer nano zero modes, you can check my sources. The link will also be found in the video description for easy access. The source to the images can be found there too. Thank you very much.